Hello friends, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in Revit 2018 Imperial. If you have been following along, go and open the file 00_034_DIAB_I. You can also download this file on the website. Go to the file tab and click the file tab and abort loss cursor to save as. Select project. This brings the save project as dialog box. Rename this project to 00_035_DIAB_I. Click the save button. Go to the quick access toolbar and select the open button. Navigate to the folder where you saved the exercise in this project. Scroll down and select the project 00_033_DIAB_I. Click open. You can also download this file on the website. Zoom in closer to see the profile. Now go to the edit, go to the family edit panel and select load into project. Revit load this file into the project. If you have more than one file open in Revit, Revit gives you a dialog box to select the file that you want to load the profile. Go to the architectural tab and click the down arrow under the wall command and select reveal again. Click the edit type button. Click the down arrow next to default and select the profile that you just load, which is the 00_033_DIAB_I. Click OK to return to close the dialog box. Zoom in into this area. Avoid your mouse cursor and select the face of this wall. Move and select to this part. Click Start Reveal button. Select this object and select this. Click Start Reveal. Select and select. Click Start Reveal. Click Modify button on the selection panel. Go to the project browser and double click the right elevation to open the right elevation view. Zoom in into this area. Select this reveal and change this distance to 1 inch. Press enter to see the result. Select this reveal, change this distance to 5 inches. Press enter to see the result. Select this reveal, change the distance to 1 foot 1 inch. Press enter. Select the reveal, change this distance to 1 foot 5. Select the reveal, 1 foot 9. Change this value to 2 feet 1. Select the reveal. If you select the wrong object, click the modify button to deselect. Select the reveal. Change the offset to 1 foot to 2 feet 5. Select the reveal. Change this offset to 2 feet 9. Select the reveal. Change the value to 3 feet 1. Select the reveal. Change the value to 3 feet 5. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the default 3D view. Click the down arrow under the wall command and select reveal again. Select the face of this wall and the face of this wall. Click Restart Reveal. Select this face, this face. Click Restart Reveal. Select this face, this face. Click Restart Reveal. Select this face, this face. Click Restart. Click Modify button on the selection panel. Zoom in close. Select this reveal. Change this value to 3 feet 9. Press enter. Change the value to 4 feet 1. Press enter. Select this. Change the value to 4 feet 5. Press enter. Select this reveal. Change the value to 4 feet 9. Press enter. Select the reveal. Change the value to 5 feet 1. Press enter. Select the reveal. Change the value to 5 feet 5. Press enter. Select the reveal. Change this value to 589. Press enter. Select this. Change the value to 681. Select this reveal. Select the reveal. You can also go to the property palette and change the offset from level to the property palette. Change this value to 6 feet 5. Change the value to 6 feet 9. Change the value to 7 feet 1. Press enter. Change the value to 7 feet 5. Press enter. With the reveal still selected, go to the grid panel and select grid similar. Select this face, restart reveal. Select this face, restart the reveal. Select this face, click the modify button. Change the value to 7 feet 9. Change the value to 8 feet 1, press enter. Change the value to 8 feet 5, press enter. Select this reveal. Change the value to 8 feet 9, press enter. Select this reveal. Change the value to 9 feet 1, press enter. Select the reveal. Change the value to 9 feet 5, press enter. Click the grid similar command. Select this reveal and this reveal. Click the modify button. Select the reveal that you just created and change this value to 9 feet 9 if yours is not 9 feet 9. Click the modify button. Zoom out to see the result. Now you see, because we give the face of the area where we want to reveal it a different color, you can see the reveal. If really the color that we assigned to the project, it should have been difficult to see the reveal clearly. Zoom out, hold down the mouse, the middle mouse button and pan. Hold down the shift key and the middle mouse button to orbit into this area. Go to the project browser and double click the ground floor plan view. Zoom in into this area. Go to the modify tab, geometry panel and select the wall joint command. Click on this area. Now we want to change the butt of this wall. As you can see, this wall is crossed and this wall butts to this wall. We want to change that. Click the next button. Now this wall is... Click the next button again. Click next. Alright, this is exactly what we are looking for. Come to this area and click the click. You see this short line shows that this wall cross between these two walls. We want this wall to cross at the edge of this wall. So click the next button. Click the next button again. Click next. Continue to click next until we get the result that we want. Alright, now this wall is cross this wall. This is the result that we are looking for. Click the modify button. Now go to the default 3D view. Click the architectural tab. Click the down arrow under the wall command and select the reveal. Click to place a reveal in this face. Restart reveal. Click. Restart reveal. Click. Restart reveal. Click. Restart reveal. Click. Restart reveal. Click the modify button. Now go to the project browser and double click the front elevation view to open that view. Zoom in close. Select this reveal. Change this value to 1 inch. Select this reveal and change the value to 5 inch. Change the value to 9 inch. Change the value to 1 foot 1. Change the value to 1 foot 5. Okay, click cancel. Let's leave this one and create another reveal for this area. Click the down arrow under the wall command and select the reveal command. Click to place. Restart reveal. click restart review. Click restart review. Click restart review. Click and click the modify button. Zoom in closer so that you can see the temporal dimension clearly. Select this reveal. Make sure that the value is 5 inches. This, make sure that the value is 9. This, make sure that the value is 1 foot 1. This, and change the value to 1 foot 5. Press enter. Select this, change the value to 1 foot 9. Press enter. This, change the value to 2 feet 1. Press enter. Select this reveal and change the value to 2 feet 5. Select this reveal and change the value to 2 feet 9. Change the value to 3 feet 1. Select the value to 3 feet 5. Select the value to 3 feet 9. Change the value to 4 feet 1. Press enter. Select this reveal and change the value to 4 feet 5. Select this reveal, change the value to 4 feet 1. Select this reveal, change the value to 4 feet 5. Zoom, select the reveal, change the value to, let me select. Sometimes it's necessary to select the reveal that's already in place. That can help you to figure out the next value. I'm going to select this. The value is 4 feet 5. Since the increment is 4 inches, the next value should be 4 feet 9. So select this reveal and change this value to 4 feet 9. Press enter. 5 feet 1. 5 feet 5. 5 feet 9. 6 feet 1. 6 feet 5. 6 feet 9. With the reveal still selected, select the grid similar command in the grid panel. You can also type CS on your keyboard. Click to press the reveal. Restart reveal. Click. Restart reveal. Click. Restart reveal. Click. Restart reveal. Click. Click the modify button. Select the reveal. Change the value to 7 feet 1. Select the reveal. Change the value to 7 feet 5. Select the reveal. Change the value to 7 feet 9. Select the reveal. Change the value to 8 feet 1. Select the reveal. Change the value to 8 feet 5. Select the reveal. Change the value to 8 feet 9. Select the reveal, change the value to 9 feet 1. The reveal still selected, go to the grid panel and select grid similar or type CS on your keyboard. Click restart reveal, click restart reveal, click the modify button. Select the last reveal and change the value to 9 feet 9 if it's not 9 feet 9. Click the zoom to fit command. Go to the default 3D view. Zoom out by rolling the mouse wheel backward and pan into the middle of the drawing. Hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit to see the result. Click the zoom to fit command and go to the quick access toolbar and click the save command. We'll continue to the reveal in the next tutorial. If you like this tutorial, please like it and share it to your friend. If you have any question, please leave a comment below. If you want to continue this tutorial or any other tutorial on my channel, please subscribe. Thanks very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next class. Goodbye.